Yeah.
Thank you. Our next guests have, in the course of their long career in pop music, sold over 40 million records. Justin Hayward and John Lodge have been the voices and the composers behind some of the biggest hits of the last 21 years as members of the Moody Blues. Well, we'll be listening to a bit of their new LP a bit later on, just as soon as we can get our act together. But meanwhile, good morning to you both.
Morning.
Good morning.
It says on the back of your new album, Sur la Mer, it is now 21 years since we first heard the days of future past and were captivated, seemingly forever, by Nights in White Satin.
Seems like yesterday.
Yeah. Does it really?
Yeah. No.
It doesn't to me, actually. 21 years, that's a long time, yeah. Isn't it? Happy, sure. Happy anniversary for coming in.
Thank you very much.
Great, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, yeah.
Does it feel like 21 years?
Well, no, but, you know, the compact disc has just been released of Days of Future Past as well, so
glad
that
you
comes
that.
Really
you
quickly.
That in as well, didn't you?
Oh, the new
compact disc.
That's
the compact disc single.
Yeah. Oh, this is the compact disc single. I didn't even know they existed.
I didn't just
oh, they're great. Lovely quality, yeah.
Big little thing.
Yeah.
Yes, incredible, isn't it? Yes, it is. And that's the single off the new album. I know you're out there somewhere.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Which we will be playing in a moment.
When we can get our act together.
And we'll tell you when we'll be playing.
Which is what we were talking about when you suddenly came back to us.
That's right.
Oh, hey, we've got our act together. Shall we have a... let's listen. Let's see what it's going to be like. Let's listen to I Know You're Out There Somewhere from the Sur La Mer album.
See the way and I've left behind the empty streets that once inspired my life, and the strength of the emotion is like thunder in the air, 'cause the promise that we made each other haunts me to the end.
Very clever. I didn't realise you could be a cheapest video we've ever made.
Yes,
the we'll have to explain what happened today, because we were going to play the new video, but the video that came in the box was right, the label was right, because the video on it was completely
Gracie
different.
Gracie Fields, obviously.
Completely different number.
Dear, dear.
So unbelievable.
Sensational, my verdict on that.
Yeah,
that's,
right.
I think that's terrific.
Very good.
Really
good.
Thank
the
you
guitar
much.
Work, sensational.
Yes, it was good. We should have done the steps as well.
Oh, yes, you should have. Now, look, you brought along some little bits of memorabilia just to mark the 21 years.
Yes, that's right. I mean, we don't carry this stuff around with us all the time, but we were.
We carry a bag all the time.
No.
That is.
That's the Golden Ticket Award from Madison Square Gardens. What was that,
100,000 seats.
When was that?
1973, I think.
Yeah.
74.
Yeah. Great.
I've kept it in the attic ever since.
Yeah.
What else?
That's what Nights in White Satin at numero uno.
Oh, the Cashbox Top 100.
I love all the other people in the charts. Number two, Elvis. Three, Chuck Berry.
Good Lord. Yeah, you've got Elvis at number two.
Yeah, Johnny Nash in the top 10. Oh. Curtis Mayfield, it's great.
You were top of an impressive pile.
Yeah,
it's
fantastic. It's
a great pile to be top of.
Can you remember it when you were first told you were number one?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's a wonderful moment.
Oh, it's fantastic, yes.
And?
That's a good one, too, because that's a poster from our first American tour that we did see Moody Blues. Is at the Fillmore West. Bill Graham from the Fillmore West in San Francisco. And it's not very clear, but that's our name. And then this is Chicago Transit Authority with the supporting band. CTA, who are now just called Chicago.
That's right, yes.
That's,
right.
That's what he did before he started preaching then, Billy Graham.
it's not that.
Oh,
Bill
not
Graham.
The same one, I'm sorry.
Bill Graham.
But of course, Fillmore, that was the, I mean, English artists to go to the Fillmore in California.
It's like 1967, that is.
Huge
flower power and
everything.
Bells are ringing.
That's right, a bit like that picture we saw of you there in the Bluebell Field or whatever
it was. That's right.
Lovely days.
Yes.
Great.
Chicago Transit Authority, Justin was just saying when we were in our last commercial break, they went on to become Chicago, he said. They were just kids at the time. Well, so were you.
Yeah, course, well, we were still at school, I think.
We were actually, if you look on the new Sur La Mer album, there are pictures of us about the age when we were did our first...
Inside.
Where's the inside?
Where are you looking? Take the inside.
Oh, after the next break, perhaps we can have a look at the inside.
Yes. We're very highly organised this morning. I was just saying it's not a very interesting inside, bit I've got. But anyway, yes, you were saying that, I mean, it was just so lovely in those days, flower power, long blonde hair, all the rest of it. Is it still as exciting these days?
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Oh, it's easy.
The touring bit. The touring bit is fantastic for us, yeah.
You've got a tour coming up, haven't you?
Yeah.
Start July 27 in America.
Oh, yeah, we're coming over here.
Well, we hope to in the late autumn.
Why start in the States then? What's the reason for that?
It seems to become part of our. It seems to become part of our.
They've got these type of venues that we really enjoy playing, which are like outdoor, indoor amphitheatres. And for the last, three, 4 years, we've been playing those through the summer.
Yes, I was just wondering if the popularity in the States was perhaps greater than it is here, even.
Well, our biggest success has always been
in America. But they do have these huge amphitheatres outdoors, and it's sort of the festival atmosphere of the late 60s, early 70s, you know, where everyone arrives 1 o'clock in the afternoon and sit round on the lawns, and it's a superb atmosphere.
It can be that good at Wembley, can't it, in
yes,
summer?
Oh, yes, of course.
Sure.
Yes, of course.
And haven't you got a Christmas concert coming out, which is a charity one as well?
Yeah, we'll be touring here, I think, around about Christmas time.
Yes, the week before Christmas.
Oh,
there's the inside.
It's going to be very difficult to see.
Because the album was called Sur La Mer, we all thought we've all got pictures of us when we were kids. You know, everybody has them there on the beach and there.
Yeah, but it's actually not called Sur La Mer because it has anything to do with the sea, has it?
Well, there's a catch. When we first started making the album, we said, "Well, where should we start?" And somebody said,
"On Thebes,
on the sea, the middle note of the piano."
Yeah, on middle sea, and that's so the whole thing is on the sea.
So Sur La Mer.
It's a very summery album, and we wanted the sort of the naive.
Trying to justify it.
No, it's the naivety. It's the naivety of what's the first thing you learn in French? You know, one of them, of course, is Sur La Mer.
Yeah,
and it's this.
Or
something.
La Plume de Matin.
Yes, why didn't you call it La Plume de Matin?
We couldn't spell that, though, let's be honest.
Anyway, it has a very nice picture of Le Four d'Antibes by Nicolas de Staël in 1955.
Yeah.
That's the latest Moody Blues album. We'll be talking a bit more to them, a bit more sensibly later on. Right now, we'll take a break.